1986. Nintendo had just made Super Mario, and although Sega was still very popular in arcades, they had nothing on Mario. Sega had to create a game series that could compete with Mario. Sega needed a mascot. Most people would immediately say Sonic, but Sonic wasn't made for another 5 years. Sonic was also designed for the Sega Genesis. I'm talking about the Sega Master System, Sega's first home console and one of the most underrated game systems of all time. This was the direct competition to Nintendo, an 8-bit system that never really stood out because of the overwhelming success of the NES. At the time, Sega's mascot was Opa Opa, the spaceship from Phantasy Star. A good game, but it was only really popular in Japan. Sega would need a mascot that could be compared to Mario, and Alex Kidd was a perfect match. Alex Kidd in Miracle World had almost 100% positive reviews when it was released. It's considered one of the best Sega Master System games, and for good reason too. It's a long adventure game that's both very fun and incredibly challenging. The environment and gameplay is constantly changing, from running to swimming to flying, which I know doesn't sound very intense, but this was a rare thing back then. You can also collect money to buy several things, such as vehicles to help you get through the levels. This is a very solid game. This game is rich and colorful, cheerful, and fast-paced. But don't let the design trick you, this game is infuriatingly difficult. You have to survive 17 levels with only 3 lives. After that, it's game over, back to the beginning. You have no hope of ever finishing this game. I do not consider this a game flaw. In fact, video games are supposed to be challenging, but there's a big difference between a game being challenging and a game being completely unfair. Instead of boss battles, you play rock, paper, scissors. If you lose, you die. This game is complete chance. It shouldn't be a gamble if you win or lose a game. It's supposed to be about skill. Even if you played this game perfectly without dying, which would be completely ridiculous as it is, there's a very slim chance you would still win. What the hell were they thinking? Alex Kidd The Lost Stars is nothing like the original. Find the miracle ball. This game is all about speed. You have to rush to the goal before time runs out, but be careful because hitting an enemy or falling will cause you to lose time. There's 6 levels in the game, each of which was obviously designed by somebody on drugs. The game technically has 12 levels, but the game simply repeats itself with an increased difficulty, which is just plain laziness, a common side effect of drugs. Find the miracle ball. Okay, I love that. He's the miracle ball. Now, why did that guy jump?
I love those boxes. It just shoved its finger in my eye.
But you know, Alex Kidd doesn't have time to complain. He's got to get that miracle ball. The last round that I made it to in this game was this graveyard. See, this game is actually somewhat fun. What the fuck? That guy is shitting out skulls. This game is messed up, but the next game is even stranger. Alex Kidd in High Tech World is the worst game in the series. It has a really dumb plot, it's incredibly slow, and there's not a single fun moment in this entire game. So you need to talk to everybody in your mansion, trying to find pieces of a map to the town that you live right next to. How brilliant. I'm gonna need help. This is obviously a police matter. Every little thing you have to do in this game will just make you angry. This is so stupid. Why should I have to do this shit? Alex Kidd is a prince. Once you complete your map, you have to journey through a forest to reach the town. It's filled with ninjas that, for whatever reason, want you dead. This is incredibly hard. Every time you die, you return to the main menu, and you will die a lot.
Yum, I want a hamburger. Hell yeah, I want fries. Ah, this game is so stupid.
So once you finally reach the arcade, the game is over. Luckily, in this last game, he redeems himself.
Alex Kidd in Shinobi World is a very fun game. Unfortunately, I'm very bad at this game, so this review is going to be pretty damn quick. This game has the perfect combination of classic Alex Kidd gameplay with the style of Shinobi. Well, just in case you've never played Shinobi, this is the title screen, and this is some gameplay footage for you.
So now that you're a Shinobi expert, you can tell that they did a really good job with this game. It's colorful and it's fun. Alex Kidd has the worst luck, too. Everybody is constantly trying to kill him. I mean, just leave him alone. He's gonna grow up to become Bruce Willis or Liam Neeson. I'm pretty disappointed in myself. I got completely stuck right here and eventually turned it off. But, you know, this review is still really embarrassing.
After the 80s, Alex Kidd was completely replaced by Sonic, and the franchise was forgotten. Sega was at the top of their game during the 90s with the Genesis, but after the unsuccessful launch of the Sega Saturn, their company was in real danger. The PlayStation took the throne. The Nintendo 64 arrived 2 years later, so Sega made one final attempt to get back into the competition. They made the Sega Dreamcast, one of my all-time favorite game systems. It looks great, and it has an amazing selection of games. But Sony had a large fan base, and just 2 years later they released the PlayStation 2. Sega was finished. Within 1 year of the PS2's release, Sega switched from being a major competitor to being a third-party software designer. As Sega was being destroyed by Sony, a Japanese RPG was released on the Dreamcast right before they shut down. In the game, you're hired by Sega to try to save the company from the evil Dogma, which represents Sony. It's an RPG and a simulation game, and there are tons of Sega characters and Sony references. Alex Kidd makes an appearance in this game. He's talking with one of his friends at the park. He talks about how a long time ago, he was in his own series of very popular games, and how he went head-to-head against Mario. But somewhere, something went wrong. Sonic became famous and Alex Kidd was no longer wanted by anybody. Alex Kidd is no longer a kid. He's now in his 30s, and he's given up. In my opinion, this is one of the saddest and most powerful video game moments of all time. It's not just a video game character complaining that nobody plays him. It's much deeper than that. This entire video game is one giant thank you to all of Sega's fans, and one final goodbye from the dying company. I grew up with Sega, just like how our parents grew up with Atari. Out of respect of Sega, you should dust off your old game system and re-experience those childhood games, if not just for the nostalgia. Sega will never truly be dead until everybody stops playing.